welcome back to our channel. I'm Chantal.
I'm Jesse.
And today we are doing, what song is it? 13 and 14.
Yes.
This is song 13. We're going to try 13, 14, 15, or just 13, 14.
We'll see how it goes.
We'll see just based off of, we don't want to commit to anything, yeah. But this is Epiphany on the Taylor Swift album Folklore.
And we're just coming off of
Mad Woman.
So yes. This is...
like, and if you guys haven't watched that already, I would have released today. So if you guys haven't watched that already, make sure you go over to that one just because there was a lot of feelings in that one for me. So mm-hmm. I'm a little bit nervous to finish this
off. Honestly, this whole album has been like...
this whole album has put me on an emotional roller coaster. And I mean, it's been a good emotional roller coaster. It's got me thinking a lot about a lot of different things. So
we're about to have an epiphany.
I know, I'm really nervous about this one. I'm so nervous. Okay, let's get into it.
Oh Jesus, here we go.
Can we get you to cry this time? Why do I have to be the... I'm not normally the sappy one. Listen, in our relationship, he is more of like the softy than I am. But I mean, like these songs, like I know here it looks like I'm the softy, but I think it's because I'm going through what the songs are representing.
I have a different... my heartstrings work differently.
There's one person, and I know you're watching this video. One person. You know him very well. Give us something that's going to hurt him, okay? Let's give us something, please.
Don't hurt me.
Not hurt him, but like, you know, make him... put him in his feels. I know you know who I'm talking about, so please make sure you comment and give us something good.
Okay, here we go. Epiphany. What's up? Wow, I don't think Mr. Miyagi's on the
dance. I'm so nervous. I'm a little anxious.
Oh, yeah.
Let me just start off with that. It literally just gave me, like, it went straight to the soul. Yeah, like, that gave me goosebumps.
Yeah,
like, the way she started off this song.
Well, I think it sounded like she was talking about war there for a second, is what that kind of sounded like. Like, on the beach, she's coming off, he's bleeding, sir, like, all this, you know what I mean? And then it's, like, some things you just don't want to talk about, which she's literally not talking about it directly, you know what I mean? She's delivering it in a way that we know what she's talking about, but it's...
but it also could be a personal war instead of a literal
war. I just mentioned like as it just generalized.
But her voice in this one is... I'm nervous to finish.
I think it might be slow like this too for the whole
thing. I think it might be, yeah.
So.
With your eyes, sir, with your eyes, full
I know, this is a power. powerful song.
I get the goosebumps.
This is a powerful song. Her voice in this song, I think, gives it so much more power behind it.
That piano key for each one, and she's following it.
This is a really good song.
And she's doing it, like, the way that she's saying these things is just, like, it's meant to be.
Like, you feel it in your heart. Yeah.
Oh.
Itself, it's basically just saying, like,
this is PTSD.
We're in this together. Like, when we served together, we fell together, we felt it all together, and like, you get only 20 minutes to sleep, and in that, you get an epiphany of something better.
Yeah.
And I feel like, the song
trying to make sense
crazy.
Of the things you see, because realistically, we, as human
you
beings,
can't,
we're not supposed to be seeing evil things like that. Like, it's, and it truly is, it's trauma.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, really, it is. Yeah. It's trauma, and it's PTSD. Like, it's like,
yeah,
a lot of really messed up people from things that have
and I
been
think
witnessed.
I, that's the thing, and even like in everyday life, people suffer trauma and stuff. And it's the biggest thing is to acknowledge it, to work through it. Don't hide it. Don't put a facade on. Don't put a face on that you're okay. If you're not okay, reach out. Ask for help. Seek
or at
whatever
least, like,
you
push
need.
Yourself to, like, we know it's, like, I know
it's
like,
not
ridiculously
easy.
Hard
yeah.
sometimes, and it, and in a lot of cases, like, you witness something that's so just, I don't even know the word, sorry guys, my nose is so itchy, just so damaging, you know, whether it be emotionally, mentally, like, physically, you know, like, who knows, whatever it is, but it's like, it's so damaging that it's like,
you gotta work through it.
You know, your mind puts up this wall that you have to
break it
forever
down.
You're forever in battle.
Yeah. And the biggest thing is when you put on, it's almost like instead of on your mind, it's more like your heart. You put walls around your heart, and it's like you gotta knock those down, because being vulnerable is when you can be the most authentic.
It is your mind, though, because they're talking about, like, visually seeing.
Yeah, that's
like,
true. Yeah,
like,
you're right.
You know, like, messed up situations and stuff like that. You know what I mean? Where it'd be, like, more of your heart in, like, a personal situation. But this is, like...
Yeah, I get what you're saying.
You know what I mean? But I know what you mean, though. Like, it does work both ways.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Thank you.
What'd you think?
What? This one was a little bit different than the other ones, I feel. But at the same time, it's not.
It's I feel like this whole album is just about... It's a lot about your mind and what's going on in your mind and your head and different situations that impact you. Exactly, in your heart and in your soul. And this is just another one. Whether you take it to be a literal war reference or if you take it to be a personal war reference, you can... It's all about what's going on in your mind, what's going on in your heart, what's going on in your soul, right? Trauma. Like, you're trying to figure out, you're trying to work your way through. Like, that's what all of... I think all of this is... This whole album is based on, like, you're trying to work through some stuff. And so I think this is just another one. Like, acknowledge when... It's just it's so important to acknowledge when you are... When you're, like, not doing good. When something's affecting you. Like, don't just shove it off to the side. I mean, when you try to pretend that... Pretend or... Put on the facade, like I said previously, that you're okay, that everything's okay, is when unfortunately we have situations in the world that turn out to be detrimental to an individual person, a family.
It could be
a multitude of different things. It could go all the way to the crazy things that we've seen go on in schools and stuff. Like, if you're not truly connected with your emotions and your mind and your heart and your soul,
they will run
that's
you.
When we have situations where people snap and you can't control yourself at that point, right? So it's so important to acknowledge what's going on with yourself. Like, you absolutely just can't pretend like it's nothing. And that's
That's where, like again, it's not easy, but like, meditating can help in that way.
For sure.
You know what I mean? You don't even have to meditate, but just like take time. I found to do it as a challenge to anybody who wants to do it. Just take 20 minutes of your day every day, and just be by yourself, and just acknowledge your life for what is going on in that moment. Yeah. What is happening around you? Are you okay? Feelings you've had? Just take 20 minutes.
Even just like, and in those 20,
so much more.
Yeah, and in those 20 minutes, just like, try to find one thing that you're grateful for.
Yeah.
One thing that, you know, maybe what's the one thing that bothered you today? What's the one thing that stressed you out that you didn't understand? What's one situation that made you mad? Like, acknowledge your emotions that you're feeling, and I feel like you're able to release them. You sleep better. You can relax. Yeah, you can. Sleep better. Just like, you're just more happy. Yeah. Also, the next day you can wake up with just like a, okay, I'm ready for today. Where if you let it all build, it turns out to be an explosion. And I mean, I feel like we've all been there, we've all done it. But it's so important to take the personal time to reflect, to dig in to the things that you felt that day. And I mean, I don't do 20 minutes every day. But I do try my best to reflect on the week, just because I think if I do daily for me, it's more overwhelming for me, where if I can look back at the whole week and be like, okay, what should I work on, like, for next week? What should be better? Where did I make maybe a misstep?
Well, you don't have to, like, set goals. Like, I don't know, I think you may have misunderstood whatever, but that's okay.
No, it's not about setting goals.
It's just like, I just mean like being connected with yourself.
Yeah, just like acknowledge everything. That's what I'm saying. Yeah. Same thing. I think we're just saying it differently. Yeah. Yeah. This was a great song.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's Epiphany.
Yeah.
Yeah. Literally.
Yeah. Yeah. Moving on to the next one. Sorry.
Okay, let's do it. So we got, this is
Betty.
Number 14. Oh, these are two big ones back to back. Oh, hang on there. I'll be back in 1 second.
So number 14, Betty from the Taylor Swift Folklore album.
Mm-hmm. This one I'm not sure. Maybe Betty's a person in her life, or...
Maybe it's an analogy.
Just an analogy for something. Who knows with this one?
make assumptions about why you switched your homeroom, but I think it's cause of me. Betty, one time I was riding on my skateboard when I passed your house, it's like I couldn't breathe. You heard the rumors from Inez, you can't believe a word she says most times, but this time it was true. The worst thing that I ever did was what I did to you. But if I just showed up at your party, would you have me? Would you want me? Would you tell me to fuck myself? Or lead me to the garden? In the garden, would you trust me if I told you it was just a summer thing? I'm only 17, I don't know anything, but I know I miss you.
So you hurt somebody. Bad enough. That,
she's acknowledging
that
she hurt them.
Yeah. Well, yeah, it was bad enough that that's the way that she felt she had to go.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm.
I think it's just taking responsibility for her portion of whatever went on, which I think we've talked about so many times, you have to acknowledge. And I feel like if you can acknowledge what you've done... My biggest thing, though, is just... Yeah. I don't know. Yeah. Yeah.
What were you going to say?
Oh, I was just going to say, like... It's just hard, because, like, how she said, like, if I just showed up at your party, so obviously she's not invited.
Yeah.
So at that point, like, is tit for tat worth it? Like, you, I hurt you, so should you be hurting... Like, is it worth hurting me over? Like, does that make you feel better? Like, that's kind of... You know, that's the vibe I'm getting
from
it.
Yeah, so this one actually relates pretty hard, though. Yeah. Now that I think about it differently, this one hits home a little bit differently.
Yeah.
So this may be another tier one.
Betty, I know where it all went wrong. Your favorite song was playing from the far side of the gym. I was nowhere to be found. I hate the crowds, you know that. I saw you dance with him. You heard the rumors from Inez. You can't believe a word she says most times, but this time it was true. The worst thing that I ever did was what I did to you. But if I just showed up at your party, would you have me? Want me, would you sell me to go fuck myself, or lead me to the garden? In the garden, would you trust me if I told you it was just a summer thing? I'm only 17, I don't know anything, but I know I miss you.
Basically, like, she got picked up, she dreamt of you all summer long, mm-hmm. like, just a conversation they were trying to have, and try to, like, yeah.
Okay.
Betty, I'm here on your doorstep, and I planned it out for weeks now, but it's finally sinking in. Right now is the last time I can dream about what happens when you see my face again. The only thing I wanna do is make it up to you. So I showed up
Yeah.
It's just like a lot of hurt, like, but again, she's carrying too much of the guilt on herself, and that's what I get from this song is, obviously we don't know the context of what she did, but I feel like...
Well, it's kind of like that, yeah, when you're like, by yourself and you have time to think about it, and then you start to just stack.
Yeah.
And you just keep stacking.
Well, and you're piling it all onto you. You're taking all the responsibility for the situation, and I think that's the hard part. I mean, it's brave of her to show up at the party. I think, like, that is... It's something that would be a hard decision to make.
Wait, she said, dude, thought about it for weeks, about just thinking about what your reaction is to see my face.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Let alone all the people, the location, the time, like, mood. Like, there's so many different factors that can affect that.
Yeah. Yeah. I relate to parts of this song. And so I think that's why it's just taking me back a little bit. Because specifically on the event focus part, I've had a situation where that was something that was in my mind. Should I just show up? Should I just... prove to you that I do care, that it is more to me than this. It's an internal struggle for sure, so I can feel it when she was saying that. Like, it just took me back to where I was at a couple weeks ago, and so it's truly a decision that's hard to make. I mean, it's brave, it's, because you don't know, like she said, like, are you gonna hug me? Are you gonna tell me to go F off? Are you gonna, like, what are you gonna do? Like, you don't know what the reaction of another person is going to be or what a group of people is going to be. So I think that you can definitely feel the struggle and the pain and the hurt and the...
It's a good way to see the other side.
Yeah. Like, you want to try and make it better, but you don't know how, what's going to work, what's not going to work. Like, so it's a powerful song. It's a powerful song. Like, you can definitely, you feel this, like, her struggle, the back and forth. So, I can respect, like, I respect this song and I respect what she was going through. And I mean, it's not easy.
No.
It's not an easy decision. And I mean, if she did choose to, like, if this was a real situation for her, if she did choose to show up, I hope it all worked out for her. And if you guys choose to just show up, I hope it works out the best for you. Because, I mean, that's brave.
Always go in with good intentions.
Yeah. With, like, you just, like, don't go honest in to, intentions. Like, make a, like, to fight, a, like, to fight or to make it worse than it already is. Like, if you truly want to make it better and you think showing up is going to do that, then show up. But if you think showing up could make it worse, then don't take the risk. Because then, you know, it could be irreparable in the end. And if, obviously, this relationship means a lot to her, so you have to truly think about what the next step is. And in my situation specifically, time is what we need. You can't show up in a situation like that because both sides need time. And I can recognize that. And so I think when you really dig in and you can recognize the situation for what it is, because you're the only one that really knows, then that's what you have to do. And if that's what you think is right, then that's what you think is right. And just own that decision. And so, But just make sure you really think about that choice before, and you're doing it, like Jesse said, with the right intention in your heart, and you're not going to make things bigger than it already is, because...
Well, if you're just going to keep going back to hurt the other side, then...
Then what's the point?
Then you... I mean, both sides just deserve the comeback exactly. this time, if you're going to keep doing it. Somebody has to step out of the cycle.
Yeah.
Someone has to. This goes back to even the Ariana Grande sense. Or not the Ariana, so my bad, apologies. The Rihanna song.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Somebody has to step out of the cycle.
You have to. You have to push yourself out.
And be honest about it.
You have to sometimes push yourself out of the normalcy
mm-hmm.
of the...
What's comfortable.
Yeah. And sometimes pushing yourself out of the comfort zone of just throwing hate is not...
Find comfort exactly. in uncomfort.
You gotta be kind. yeah. That's my true... What all I'm trying to focus on right now for the next however long is just kindness. Focus on kindness. What does it take to be... I mean, how hard is it to be kind to somebody? To think about and put yourself in their shoes. Think about the situation from both sides before you make a decision that alters both sides.
Yeah, don't react. Like, you know, be proactive. Don't just react to everything at first thing. You know, because then eventually, especially for people that react very quickly without ever thinking, those types of people tend to continue to just fire shots afterwards, which is just, I mean, it's just,
it's not worth it.
Yeah, it's just,
it's not, I mean, that you gotta realize, like, what the price is and what you're willing to pay. So, is the price giving up who you are, is that worth it for you? Then do that. Is the price just admitting that you were wrong this time, take it on and move on? Then do that. But you have to be the one that figures it out. Only you can make that decision. Even in the situation that I've been talking about in most of the songs, I'm not going to go into details about it, but Jesse is more of an outsider in this specific situation, and so he does give me his opinion and what he believes might be right for me, because he knows me better than anybody knows me, and so I do take his opinion, but I still make the decision in the end, because I'm still the one that has to live with it. Yes, he...
Yeah, but that's always been something for us, though. You've always made your own choices, do your own thing. And that's it, and that's the beauty of it, though, is because I can just tell you, or you ask me something, and I just, okay, well, take it how you want it.
Yeah, this is my opinion.
Yeah, take it how you want
it. This is how I see it, and now go like, do what you gotta do.
Yeah, don't, but then, like, on the other side, too, like, if you're looking at it from my perspective, it's like, don't, you know, be an ass afterwards because it's not what you wanted to hear.
Yeah.
Or they didn't listen to what you wanted to say. Like, that's just BS. You know?
And sometimes it is hard. It's hard to hear somebody else's point of view because you want them to agree with you or mm-hmm. you want them to see it the same way you see it. But Jesse and I see things very differently. We process things very differently. So I think in both of our, in different situations for both of us, the other person can be kind of the clear mind and can be like, hey, like, what
one,
about this?
Yeah, one person's always out.
Exactly.
Sense, if that makes any sense.
Well, and I think that's the biggest thing that Jesse and I have always personally focused on is when he's going through something that doesn't necessarily involve me, then that's him.
Mm-hmm.
And I let him deal with it and I let him react to it. I let him handle it, mm-hmm. and I'm just here for support. If he needs me, I'll listen. If he's hurt after a decision he's made, I'll pick the pieces up, and it's vice versa. It's same thing for me. He is that person. So we try to keep certain situations in our life separate, but still together, obviously, because we live our lives together. But when it's a personal thing going on with you and somebody else, we tend to just let that person handle it, and we're there to support and to help and to be that shoulder to cry on, to be that punching bag if that's what you need, just so that we can kind of...
Don't get us wrong, though. Both of us, even in those situations, both of us, even on the outside, are locked and loaded, ready to go if it ever got bad.
Oh, yeah.
100%.
At the end of the day...
As much as we don't participate on the other side, to be able to have that... I guess it would be that perspective. To be able to experience that kind of perspective, to have an outside and an inside, and then be able to go back and forth, you know what I mean? You have to be like that.
Yeah. And I think the thing is, too, what's good is, I think from even day one for Jesse and I, we're quite different in a lot of ways, but to the core, we're very similar. But it's just the differences is what helps us see everything at every angle. See, like, the two of us can, when we put our heads together, we are able to really truly dig in and see different things that we wouldn't normally be able to see. So it's super cool having that relationship because it helps us to be able to decipher situations like this when you're hurt, when you're whatever. That person is kind of like the sounding board to be like, okay, but let's think about it like this. Okay, let's think about it like this. And then we just bounce back and forth until we kind of, whoever, like, let's say, for instance, my situation, we'll just bounce back and forth until I'm content making a decision on something. But we are very independent people.
Yeah.
But also codependent because we do need each other, obviously.
Well, that's 50-50.
Actually, no, sorry, let's scratch that. We don't need each other, we want each other. Mm. And I think that's the difference, is we know that we don't...
Well, that's kind of like this, though, too.
Yeah.
It's the want, rather.
Exactly. I don't need, like, I think we're both super strong individual people, and we don't necessarily need each other, we choose each other. And that's the difference. It's different from needing someone, and, like, I need that person to survive, or I want that person. I choose that person, and we both choose each other every single day, and we'll continue to choose each other till the end of time.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I mean, I think that's the unique kind of aspect of it, just because it gives you a different perspective on everything, and, you know, you get judgment on how you act in certain situations, and people can place the blame on somebody else and stuff,
yeah.
But at the end of the day... You two know what's going on, and that's all that matters,
well,
right?
Yeah, you always have somebody, like, if it's, when it's pure, you, like, somebody always has your back.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Even when you don't have
when
your own back.
When it's true, unconditional love,
yeah.
That's what I would say. It, and it doesn't have to be a significant other, it could be a family member, because there's another...
Well, yeah, whoever you confide in, yeah.
Exactly. Like, I have two people that are truly... my extreme confidants in my life. Jesse is one of them. The other person knows who they are. And I mean, they're like my absolute true ride or die. So, and then I mean, everybody.
Well, and that's what I feel like. That's why this hurts so bad.
Exactly. Because this was one of those
people.
This was one of those people.
Yeah.
And I mean, been there, done that. So it's hard. And I think realizing that maybe they weren't actually that, and obviously, if a situation can break, because no matter what Jesse and I go through, okay, let's not use Jesse. Me and another person that is my true number one, I would say if something were to happen between the two of us, we can always come back from it. We talk it out. We figure it out. Like, there's nothing, I truly believe there's nothing that we could do to each other that would break the bond that we have. And so I think that when you realize maybe that person wasn't who you thought they were, maybe that relationship wasn't what you thought it was, that hurts, and it hurts like hell. And I mean, that's part of growing and learning and all of that kind of stuff. So it's super difficult, and I can truly feel the pain that she's going through in this song. And so I appreciate everything that she had to say and the struggle that she's going through. I felt it. I've gone through it, going through it,
yeah,
whatever that looks like. So. She does.
She gets us on the brain rants. It just happens. I'm sorry, people.
All right. So this was Betty's.
Another good one.
Yeah. I think we'll wrap this video up and then we'll go.
Together.
Yeah. And we'll go into another recording for the next song. So thank you guys so much for coming back to our channel. Please subscribe. Smash that like button. Turn on the post notification bell because you don't want to miss anything. And continue to comment down below because we love hearing from you guys.
Yeah. It's become like my absolute, like I work nights. And so, like, it's my nights have gotten much, 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 much easier.
Yeah.
Being able every once in a while, I get a little comment from somebody. I'm like, oh, okay, cool. Like, it takes my mind. It when you work alone, for all my people that know what it's like to work by yourself, like, you know how hard it is sometimes. Like, so seeing your guys' comments, being able to communicate with you guys, has helped me personally a lot in that way. So I appreciate you guys in that way.
Yes, very much. We are definitely grateful. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Thanks, guys.
Peace out, guys.